In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a soft glow effect in After Effects using drop shadows. Let's get to it. So here we are in After Effects, and before we start, let me tell you that this effect looks particularly well on thin objects. That could be thin text, shapes, logos, stuff like that. I'll use text for the example, so I'm going to select the type tool. For the font, I'll go for Montserrat Thin in all caps, then click and type neon, and then I'll align this to the center of the composition. So now the concept here is very simple. We're going to add a drop shadow to the layer, then we're going to duplicate it multiple times and increase the softness on every subsequent drop shadow. And that is very great, but when we want to change the color, we need to go through every drop shadow and change the color that way. So let's be a bit smart about it. And first, we go to Effects and Presets and search for Color Control, then drag and drop it onto the layer, and then search for Drop Shadow and add it to the layer. So first, let's link the color of the drop shadow to the color control. So for that, we're going to hold the Alt key on the keyboard and left click on the stopwatch for the shadow color. And then down here, we are able to add an expression, but the only thing we need is this pick whip. So click and drag it, place it on top of the color for the color control and let go. That'll automatically fill up the code. So now just click away. So with this one, we've successfully linked the color of the drop shadow to this color control. So the way we change the color of the drop shadow is via the color control now. So if we open this and select something like purple, click OK, you can see that the drop shadow's color has changed. So now let's adjust the actual drop shadow. So I'm going to set the opacity to 100%, distance to 0, and softness to 10. Then I'm going to select the drop shadow and press Ctrl D to duplicate it. Now for the second drop shadow, I'll set softness to 50. Then duplicate it again, Ctrl D, set this one to 100, then duplicate 200, duplicate 400, duplicate, this one will be 1000, duplicate it again, and for the last one we're going to set softness to 2000 and opacity to 50. So we've created 7 drop shadows in total, and I found these values to look great, but you can experiment with different ones, maybe you find something even better. And you can see we've created a very nice and soft looking neon glow. Now let's go back to changing the color. So right now we have this purple neon glow, and if we wanted to make it say light blue, we would go all the way up to the color control and select the color for the color control, and then let's choose a different color, so maybe light blue, then click OK. And you will see that every drop shadow's color has changed based on the color control, so that is a technique I wanted to share with you. And you can also save all of these effects as a preset to quickly drag and drop it to a different layer in your new project. That is also super, super easy. So that is it for this one. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one. Peace out.